I'm standing here with the very fabulous, talented Abashia, the brains behind Hijab Fashion Week South Africa. I have to say that I'm standing on a step because if you actually know how tall she is, she's just making me look good. Abashia, this has been phenomenal. You've come down from Cape Town to Johannesburg. You've brought Cape Town weather with you today. It's freezing cold, yet we have people coming in to watch this, which tells us there's a huge need for people wanting to see what modest fashion is about. Tell me about your journey about Modest Fashion Week, because I know you've done this before in Cape Town.
Alhamdulillah, I did it 4 consecutive years, Hijab Fashion Week. Is this okay?
Speaking? It looks fantastic.
Okay, wonderful. So it's 4 consecutive years that I've been doing Hijab Fashion Week SA in Cape Town, in my hometown, which was convenient. I know the industry. I've been doing my brand, Fabrics and Hijab, for about 8 years now, and I myself needed a platform. So the other design platforms didn't conform to what I needed, and that was where the need for Hijab Fashion Week came along, because I didn't want to showcase my daughter in front of men.
Yes.
I needed a safe environment. With a fashion week, it's not a new concept. Many different other countries is doing it. With Hijab Fashion Week SA, we put a bit of a spin to it. We now did not do established brands. We're now focusing on local brands. And now with our economy now regarded as junk, what better way than helping the locals get to the next level, showcasing.
And that's what I love about it, because this serves as a platform for empowering so many Muslim women designers.
Oh, definitely.
How did you choose? It must have been difficult deciding who you were going to have showcase here, because we have an immense amount of talent in our communities, and I'm sure that wasn't easy on your part.
It wasn't. It was actually the most difficult decision I had to make. When the ad broke, when we announced Hijab Fashion Week will be coming to Johannesburg, we had over about 40 designers applying, and very quickly we created a criteria of you must be in business within 2 years, your garments must be locally manufactured, and you need to be involved in that design process. Mm. Because at the end, speaking from a designer myself, I know the work that goes behind creating a look. Mm. So that was one of the clauses, and that kind of alleviated a lot of draw a picture, move it on, and see the finished product.
Yes.
I needed the interaction and the passion. I needed to recognize the passion in that designer, and that's how we selected the designers
amazing.
This year.
From the talent you've seen that's been showcased today and tomorrow, I mean, I'm not even going to ask you firm favorites, because you're in the field as well. But do you find that there are signature brands that you can look out for and say, I know this is a South African-based designer? And do you see these designers growing as we continue?
I think that is one of the most important aspects of the criteria we set to showcase at Hijab Fashion Week. Because a lot of people think it's a fashion show, let's get on board, showcase us once and my job is done, my brand is going to launch. It doesn't work like that in this industry. This industry is hard work. It's tough. You need to be part of the industry to be relevant. You need to know who your clientele is. You need to understand what the people's looking for. And if you don't have that of wanting to be part of it, or that flair for passion, or that drive to be a successful entrepreneur in the clothing industry, you are going to find it tough. You need to be strong.
That stands out a lot for me. I have to ask you though, with so many Muslim designers up and coming, how do you find the synergy in terms of working together? Has everyone understood that, you know what, there's place for all of us if we work together? Or do you find that it's exceptionally competitive as we see out there with the rest of the design?
Competition is good. Competition is healthy. But that does bring the question of sisterhood in Islam. We want for ourselves what we want for the next person, and that is really the level of iman that I, inshallah, for myself personally, I need to grow towards.
Yes.
It was a huge challenge with Hijab Fashion. We started off on a very rough foot, but as the planning went through, we carried on over the weeks, the sisterhood came through, and we pulled off. Because the reality is, I arrived in Johannesburg on Friday, and here I am. Alhamdulillah, the Johannesburg ladies did it.
Yes.
I was merely the coordinator. Contacts, getting people on board, getting the right people to do the right work for us. Alhamdulillah, this is what sisterhood and empowering each other has brought about.
And you've actually understood what it's about, because you're a designer yourself. So it's not just someone who's come in and said, let me just make Hijab Fashion Week. You know the processes and the hard work and the stress that goes behind those designs.
I've got my scars to prove it. Alhamdulillah, yes, I do. And I think that is why it is easy to convey that sisterhood and empowerment. Because if we do make, and yes, alhamdulillah, we will make a success of Hijab Fashion Week, for many years to come, we are paving the way for more local designers. We do not want our other international brands to come over and service our community. We want our community to have faith and trust that we will service them. And we need to ensure we have that confidence from them.
Absolutely.
And this is where the player, this is a platform to create that confidence.
And for many of my viewers know, this is something I'm exceptionally passionate about, very passionate about Muslimas, about hijab, and also about Muslimas supporting Muslimas.
Definitely.
And especially proudly South African. I'm a huge supporter of that. So I'm so glad to see that you've provided that platform for designers that I think may not necessarily have received that at any other point. What are the plans going forward for Hijab Fashion Week?
I think there's huge plans. I've heard, if I may mention, our support is Crescent Lifestyle. As whispered in my ear, we are definitely taking it to another level, and that humbles me because I'm from the northern suburbs in Belhar, a small little town, small little dorp in Cape Town, that if given the time, like yourself, to listen to what it is we want to do, we can do it. Only with the support of our community and with the rest of us in the industry. So yes, inshallah, I think Hijab Fashion Week has a lot of potential to grow, not only within South Africa, throughout Africa, and inshallah, further abroad as well.
Fantastic. I wish you the greatest of success. I have no doubt we're going to be seeing much more of you and hearing much more of you. But for the rest of today and tomorrow, I wish you and all your designers the best.
Inshallah. Shukran so much. I'll see you in the front row.
You definitely will.
Shukran.